Well, let's come back home and talk to our captain. Olumide, I was talking about describing you the other time before we went to the to Sonny Young via Skype. Femi, can you help me? How do I describe this guy? You've played almost everywhere, almost every tournament.
At the junior level.
Junior, senior level.
You know, virtually every kid out of basketball, if you think of the EuroLeague, Europe and Asia, in America.
NBA, the first.
Even in South America.
Everywhere. The first player.
Yes.
To play in the NBA. Yes. Not as a draft.
Yes, to come out of.
From outside.
Yeah.
That's huge. You should be getting an award, Olumide.
Oh, well, probably I could say the glory be to God for that. It's an opportunity that I have, a great opportunity. I thank God. I believe I was blessed.
Mm. Okay, let's talk about what you are doing now. Olumide Oyedeji Foundation, how many years now?
Probably 14 years right now.
14 years of giving back to basketball, to young ones. What basketball has given you? How has it been for you? What's it like for you? 14 years.
It's probably been a roller coaster. I've probably been over there for 14 years. And I've a lot of things up and down, what you want to do, how you want to make things work out. Mm. But majority of it is just like everything I've been doing for the last 14 years, be self-funded. You know, it's kind of really been challenging. I believe I could have done more. Mm. I really want to do more, but they say cut your good according to your size. So
you don't have limitless resources.
Oh yeah, but probably I'm very, very happy with what I have. I've seen a lot of smile on youth faces, but my aim and my target is to put smiles on these young, underprivileged faces and to turn them, to make them believe in themselves, to give them hope and the future. So that they can make it, that it can be something in future for themselves, for their family, for the community, and for the country.
You started by doing something here, but the last time you began to do it as well outside of Nigeria, in the US, in London, you're having programs like this all across. What's it like for you? What's the feeling like considering what you've been doing here and the response that you're also getting from outside?
Oh, probably. I mean, what I've been doing here and what I've been doing
outside. This picture, Olumide, is here, is Nigeria.
Yeah, this one is Nigeria. The one before that was in London.
That was the one in London. We talked about the one in London the other time. You called it take a shot.
Shoot a ball, not a gun.
Pick a book, not a knife. Yeah.
Probably something like I've done it. This one in London, in South Africa, in Senegal, in Mali, in Nigeria, in Japan, Spain, China, Italy. I've done it everywhere. I've been all over. So. It's not only Nigerian, but they say charity begins at home. Mm. So I came home, and the one in London is to help the Nigerian descendants youth. Mm. Because I mean, out of 68% of our guns and knife crimes in the United Kingdom, 68% are blacks, 48%
linked to Nigeria.
48% are African, and 42% of the guns and knife crimes are linked to Nigeria. Mm. So just for them to believe, like to make them believe, okay, this is what you can do, you can get off. True guns and knife crime, stop gangs, and just through basketball and education. But don't forget, the three key things that get young men out of poverty are three. Is education, sports, and entertainment.
So the big three?
Those are the big three. Those are the major. Let me say those are the three that get the young kids out of poverty, because we have to look at it. Those are the things that change people's lives. And I was fortunate and to have a tour of it changed my life, sports and education. So that's why you have a lot of entertainment. That's why you have Whiskey, D-Bang, P-Square, Sansu Town, who also play basketball.
A
lot of people like that.
Mm-hmm. What about here? I read in the papers a couple of days ago something that you're doing for your school, your primary, your secondary school, I think.
Yeah, probably. I just donated a brand new upright and repaired a court for the Obafemi Olowo University Ile-Ife, which I went to do. I donated as a part of it.
So
where I also started from. Yeah, great Ife, always great. So you know, so I did that for the Noga for my contribution, and then cut after me. And at the same time, I was just about to repair the old court of my high school, which are Loyola. One of the best two schools in Nigeria, in Ibadan, Loyola College Ibadan. Mm. So repairing the court, renovate everything, put upright, because that was the source of my career. That was the source how I started basketball. That was what gave me a lot of things in my life, education, my foundation, which gave me name, fame, and whatsoever I have, and I give glory to God.
Femi has a few things to talk to you about as well. So let me allow Femi to say a few things.
Yeah, well, it's actually very overwhelming, you know, sitting down with this fantastic man. You've given so much, you know, to Nigeria and the game of basketball. For basketball in Nigeria, you're back home now. You see how everything goes around. What would you do, you know, as an individual, just your own contribution to help see that our league here in Nigeria, you know, things will rub shoulders at least with the North African counterparts, not necessarily
somebody who has played across.
With your experience, what things do you think we need to add? You know, one or two things that can just make, you know, the local league here, you know, be something to watch out for.
Oh, probably, and the first thing is just all about a finance, major finance awareness. Mm. I know we have to have a better awareness. We have to have a lot of people who have to know that this basketball can change their life. So, I mean, as a member of the Nigerian Basketball Federation, an athlete representative on board, I would try to make a lot of things, you know, try to create awareness, you know, because at the same time, because we can't compare our league with other countries like Tunisia, like Angola, like all those places. Is it something like they get money, they get paid? If I get paid half of money they paid Angolan's players, I'm going to be home.
Mm.
So I'm sure a lot of people of us want to be home, but we have to understand that sport nowadays is no more extracurricular activities.
This is business, right? Yeah.
So this is why you put food on the table for myself, my family, so I could help other youth, I can contribute to their life. But if I don't get this, I can't contribute. So that's why we have to look for, we have to get sponsors, we have to ask for corporate sponsors, everybody that you can, please, please, and please, although you invest in basketball, but you're not only investing in basketball, you're investing in the future of the youth of this country that their life can be changed and get them off the street.
Mm.